G'day, welcome to another Vintage Diary episode at Smithbrook Wines in Pemberton in Western Australia. Today I just wanted to show you a process and a bit of an interesting machine that runs over vintage. As you can see here, we've got a tank. It's actually a red fermenter that we've got white juice in because we've run out of tank space. But it gives you a good idea of the settling of white juice once it's been pressed out. So basically what's happened is we've crushed the fruit, we've pressed it out into this tank. It's been chilled down, as you can see all the ice over the tank, sitting at about between 0 and 2 degrees. So as the fruits come straight out of the vineyard and into the winery, it has all the solids, you know, bits of skin that have come through the press, bits of seed, whole seeds. Now this is a tank we've actually racked and taken the clear juice off the top. We've got the door open so you can see. You can see all the sludge on the bottom of the tank, and that's actually quite thick, and we've actually bulked up these gross leaves. So there's actually a number of different tanks that have bulked up into this one tank, and this is our bottoms tank now, which is obviously the bottoms of all the tanks that have come in. So at the moment, this bottoms is actually being filtered, and I'll show you the filter now. So as you can see, we've got a hose coming out of the bottom of the tank of this sludge and bottoms tank, and it's actually being filtered at the moment. Okay, so this is the machine. This is the machine that filters that bottom sludge. It's called a Rotary Drum Vacuum Filter. Looks quite complex in the way it works, but the concept is actually quite simple. So as you can see, it has a drum that rotates. Now, the layer you can see, this thick layer on the drum, which, you know, is about 1 or 2 inches thick, that's actually our filter medium, and it's a fine powder substance. It's actually called perlite. In the past, these filters have used diatomaceous earth, which has worked really well as a filter medium, but it's not been deemed safe and appropriate to use in winery conditions anymore. So the perlite actually does the same job, and all it does, all this machine does, inside this drum is a vacuum. So it actually sucks the sludge through the filter medium into the inside of the drum. So here we've got a little mono pump, which is actually coming out of the bottoms tank. Comes through these lines into this bottom reservoir here. I'm not sure if you can see, but if you look down in there, you can actually see the leaves in the bottom of this drum. So as the drum is rotating under vacuum, it sucks the leaves onto the outside of the filter medium, and then it rotates. However, if it just kept rotating and sucking the leaves onto the filter medium, it'd eventually get clogged. So what it actually does, you can see here, there's actually a really fine blade, quite sharp, that slices off a very thin layer of the filter medium that's actually been used. So the next time the drum rotates down into the reservoir, there's a clear surface of filter medium for the sludge or the gross leaves to actually adhere to. So the clear juice then ends up in this little reservoir here, and is actually pumped through the hoses into whatever tank you're transferring it to. And the juice is, almost as clear as what you get as settled, if not clearer, as settled juice. So there's a number of options you have once the juice has actually been extracted from the bottom. So you can add it back to the original tank, and you can ferment it with the settled juice. That's winemaker preference. Other winemakers prefer to send it to a separate tank, bulk it all up and ferment it separately, and then it can be used as a blending component. It can be added back to the original tank, or discarded, or sold, or if it's not the quality doesn't meet their specifications. So the concept is quite simple, but I'm always amazed when I look at this machine that someone's actually dreamt it up, using a drum and a vacuum and a filter medium that actually sticks to the outside of the drum under vacuum. But it works really, really well. It's an old design, old concept, been around for a long time. There are other new high-tech filters on the market now, but these still seem to work really well. You can get many different sizes. This is actually a tiny version of some of the bigger filters RDV filters you can get.